So up until now, we've pretty much assumed that whatever we've measured is associated with the thing that we're going to, that we want to keep track of. But in reality, there are a couple things that happen. First of all, there can be multiple objects. That's what this cute little airplane thing is supposed to look like. And in fact, radar, which is where the birthplace of multi-hypothesis tracking came from, had this problem, right? I get a whole bunch of pings back. There's a bunch of airplanes. I got to know which pings go with which airplanes in order to track all the different airplanes. Or there can be what's known as clutter. Clutter means there's a lot of stuff in the environment that has nothing to do with me. By the way, the clutter is the basis of camouflage. So when you take a look at this rattlesnake, whose contour you can just barely see here, there's all this other stuff that has nothing to do with it being a snake. So it confuses your visual system. Fortunately, when the snake starts to move, if the brush is not moving also, then you can do the association differently. But in general, clutter means that there are a bunch of measurements that are not from the thing I'm really interested in tracking. The problem is referred to as the data association problem. And the trick is to determine which measurements go with which tracks and which measurements should be ignored, which measurements cause you to start a new track. These are all things that you have to do when you do tracking. So there is a simple strategy, and that's what's indicated here. I've got a point, and I've got state, and now I take some measurements. I might just associate, I don't know, the closest measurement to my prediction. So remember when we were tracking the contours for the condensation, Izard and Blake algorithm, right? They took the distance to the nearest strong contour, as if they knew somehow that that was the right contour. They just made that assumption. Unfortunately, that doesn't always work. That clutter problem, in fact, one of the points of clutter is for it to confuse something that's trying to do that association. So those of you who watch Tom Clancy movies or read Tom Clancy books like I've done, et cetera, know that submarines will jettison these things that spin around and make noise and bubbles. At least I assume they do. They did in the movies. They did in the book. Now the torpedoes have a data association problem, right? Which thing that's making noise or making a signal should it decide is the real state? Personally, I would think seeing some, you know, many thousand ton submarine compared to this little thing spinning around wouldn't have been that hard, but obviously the torpedoes aren't that smart. But so it doesn't always work in the presence of clutter. There is a more sophisticated approach to doing this, and that is you do what's called multiple hypothesis. So multiple hypothesis says, well, okay, I've seen two things now, and maybe it's one thing, and I should associate the real object with the left measurement, and the right one is clutter. Maybe it's one thing, and I should associate the object with the right-hand one, and the left one is clutter. Or maybe it's two things. That is, a new thing should get created. Well, like I said, there's this whole area called multi-hypothesis tracking where you try to keep track of all these different things. You actually can do this using particles, all right? You can do particle filtering in a not-so-obvious way, right? Each particle is a hypothesis about the current state. So, for example, a particle can say, oh, there are two such objects, and here's where they are. Or a particle could say, there is one such object, and this one is not the right one, et cetera. So you can do that using particle filtering. And in fact, I one time told Michael Izard, I said, you know, for a lot of situations, I found that particle filtering was just a convenient way of doing multi-hypothesis tracking. And he said, absolutely. So Michael, if you're out there, I remember that conversation. I think he's on the West Coast having a great time, so good for him.